Hey guys, so today I'm sharing my monthly empties with you for the month of November. Lately, I've been doing my empties videos once a month because I have just been going through so many products, so I'm going to share all the products I used up and my thoughts on them, whether I liked them, didn't like them. We're going to start with the products that I loved and would repurchase, and then we'll work our way to the products that I did not like, wouldn't recommend, wouldn't repurchase. That's kind of the way I've been doing them lately. So let's get into it. So first I have a bar soap. Actually, you guys know I've been getting more into bar soaps for washing the body just because it's a slightly lower waste option than body wash. So I used up one from the Naughty Goat soaps. This is a little like wrapping that it came in, and they are actually sponsoring today's video. So I wanted to say a huge thank you to the Naughty Goat soaps for partnering with me on today's video. I'm so excited to share about this brand with you. I love when I get the opportunity to promote small family-run businesses like this. It makes me so happy. So they are like I said, a small family-run farm in Wisconsin, and they specialize in goat milk soaps, but they also have shaving products, lip balms. So I used up the Almond Shea soap from them. This smelled incredible. When I got the box in the mail, the whole box just smelled so beautiful. I could not wait to start using these. And the soap was so luxurious and creamy. A lot of bar soaps I feel like can be very drying on my skin, but this was not. I also felt like it lasted a pretty long time, and it just felt like such a treat for my body skin every time I used it. So I was a huge fan of that. But I wanted to also tell you guys, they are currently doing a holiday gift box that comes with two bars of soap and a lip balm. The lip balm comes in this adorable bamboo packaging. I've been using mine. This is the tinted one, and I think they also make an untinted version. You can see this is a lovely lip balm. I feel like it works great even in the nighttime, and I do like to use something a little bit heavier at night. This has been working really well for me. It's only got like a handful of ingredients. And then it also comes with two soaps. This is what they look like. This one has actual oatmeal in it, which is so cool. It's such a nice touch. I feel like you just wouldn't find that kind of special touch in a soap that you'd buy from like the drugstore or something. So I feel like this would just make such a nice gift for anyone in your life who likes to pamper themselves, or maybe somebody that should practice self-care even more than they perhaps do. It's $20, and they did give me a discount code. It's SarahRose10, and that'll get you 10% off their website. So definitely take advantage of that. But such a nice little gift idea. And a little bit more about the company, because I myself was also curious. I thought you guys might like to know too. They are a goat farm. They have a whole page on their website kind of talking about the life of their goats and how they care for the goats. So they all the goats have their own individual names and collars. They're in a free range environment, which is very important. That's something like if that weren't the case, I would not be promoting this company. They use compassionate farming practices, no kill policies, and they also give the does breaks in breeding so as not to overbreed. So I just thought that was really nice to know, and I'm sure a lot of you guys would also want to know that, since a lot of you also are cruelty-free like I am. So thank you so much to Naughty Goat Soaps for sponsoring today's video. I will have them linked down below in the description box if you are interested in checking them out. Highly recommend. Such a lovely company. It's been so nice working with them. So thank you again. And now getting into some more of my empties. So another product I used up, and this is a total favorite holy grail. I've already repurchased it. I knew I liked this product while I had it, but it was only when I ran out of this product that I realized how much I love it and like need it in my life. This is the Paula's Choice Skin Recovery Softening Cream Cleanser. I have a lot of products from this skin recovery line. In fact, I have two more skin recovery products from Paula's Choice in this video. But this is a true cream cleanser. It does not lather or foam at all, which ever since I started using topical tretinoin that was prescribed to me, I have found it is absolutely essential for me to use a non-foaming cleanser. Anytime I try to switch to a gel cleanser, even if it's one that I didn't find particularly stripping in the past, it dries my skin out. So this has been a must. It's so gentle. It doesn't irritate my skin. It has no scent to it. And this actually is a pretty big bottle, 8 fluid ounces, but when I repurchased, I actually got the jumbo size, which is like 16 ounces, I think, which is a little bit of a better cost per ounce. So I'm really excited to have it back in my life. I went like a couple of weeks without it and my skin was suffering. So I think this is gonna be a must for me year round, but especially in the winter. If you've got dry skin, any kind of like skin barrier issues, highly recommend this. It's fantastic. And for a Paula's Choice product, it's really not terribly expensive to me, especially for how good it is for my skin. I feel like It's totally worth the price. Okay, another skincare product I loved, and I honestly missed this, but I haven't repurchased it yet. This is what's leaking, I realized. but this is the 4thRay Beauty BFD Cleansing Oil. I love this. I now have some other like cleansing balms that I want to use up before I go back to this, but I'm kind of just wishing I had this back in my life. So this was, normally I do use cleansing balms. This is the first cleansing oil that I've used, and I do use the double cleanse method to remove all my makeup and sunscreen. I go in with some kind of oil-based either cleansing oil or cleansing balm, and then I go in with my Paula's Choice Softening Cream Cleanser. And this was fantastic. It does have like a light kind of herbal scent, but really nothing strong at all. I felt like it lasted me a long time too. Took me a while to go through this. And what I love about this is it really does dissolve all of my makeup, my eye makeup, mascara, anything that I've got on. And it rinses away very easily with water. I'm having this issue with other cleansing balms right now where they do work to break down the makeup, but they also are just such a pain to rinse off. Like they're kind of waxy and they're just, I have to go over it multiple times just to get it removed. That was never an issue with this. So highly recommend. It's also much more affordable than a lot of cleansing balms. I think it's like $14 on Ulta's website, which I mean, I know that's not cheap, but it's for how long this lasted me, I felt like it was a pretty fair price, especially considering how effective it was. So I love this, highly recommend. I think this is my favorite like first cleanser that I've used. I also loved the Paula's Choice Omega Plus Cleansing Balm, but this one's just much cheaper. So this is probably gonna be the one I repurchase. All right, a few more from Paula's Choice. You guys know I'm a huge fan of their products. I finally used up their Lip and Body Treatment Balm. This lasted me a solid year and a half of using it almost every single night. Now, I didn't like use this throughout the day, so that's probably why I was mainly just using it like once a day in the evenings before bed. But this is hands down the best lip balm I have ever used. It is so protective, it's thick, it doesn't have any flavor or scent, very no frills, but it's so effective, especially heading into the winter if you need like a good, reliable lip balm. Look no further. Such a great bang for your buck. I think it's $15 for this, and it's a huge, like I said, this lasted forever. And you can always get Paula's Choice products on sale because they have sales all the time. So such a great value. I cannot speak highly enough of this lip balm. And then this was actually a sample, like gift with purchase from Paula's Choice. It's their Clinical Ceramide Enriched Firming Eye Cream. I do need to cut this open and I will do that soon. I loved this. I might have even loved this a little bit more than the Glow Recipe Avocado Melt Eye Sleeping Mask. If not, they were like tied for me. This was so nice. I noticed an immediate smoothing effect in the fine lines of my under eyes, and I'm sure part of that was temporary just because of the ingredients in here. They really do just smooth out the area, kind of plump it up. Whoa, this actually has low ratings on their website. This has 3 stars. That's very surprising to me, because I loved it. Oh, it does have a low strength 0.01% retinol concentration. So I love this. I don't know why this has such low ratings, but I am considering purchasing the full size once I use up the other eye cream that I'm working on right now. This had a lot in it, like for a mini eye cream. I felt like I got a lot of uses out of it. So that was fantastic. I have these in every empties video. This is the Hello Naturally Whitening Toothpaste with fluoride in the farm grown mint flavor. Favorite toothpaste, I don't need to talk about it because I've talked about it many, many times before, but this is my favorite cruelty-free toothpaste. It's the one I always go back to. And then the last one for this category of products that I would repurchase, this is the True Earth Laundry Detergent Strips. My mom actually gave these to me because I think it was an empties video a few months ago where I talked about how I ran out of these, and so that was so sweet of her to send me some more. But I love these. This is a plastic-free laundry detergent option. It comes in these little like strips that you literally tear off. And one of those is the equivalent of like a little capful of regular laundry detergent that you'd normally use. So I love these. These were the fresh linen scent. They also have an unscented and a baby version. And it just comes in this nice paper envelope that takes up virtually no space. Oh, the only thing is be careful not to drop this like between your washer and the wall, or like you've got your washer and dryer really close together. This can easily fall between there and you might never get it back. That actually happened to us and we were able to get it out with like a long thing. But anyway, that's the only downside to this. But otherwise, huge fan. Oh, the other thing is it's kind of pricey. It's 32 loads, and I think one little envelope of these is like $20, which is just kind of pricey. I know they do have a big bulk value option as well. But I do recommend that if it's in your budget, I think it's great. All right, in the next category, and this is my largest category for this video, are the products that I liked. I felt kind of neutral about them. I probably wouldn't repurchase them, but maybe I would. They're just not like tippy top holy grail favorites. So right on top here, I have the EOS Shea Better Shave Cream in the pomegranate raspberry scent. So I was really excited to try this when EOS went cruelty-free. So exciting. I do really like their body lotion, but I don't know. I just didn't love this. Like, it was okay. The scent was really nice, a nice like fruity, sweet, pleasant scent. But it was, for one thing, it was really hard to get it out once it got to like this point, you know, and there was like a lot left in there and the pump wouldn't get it out because it's kind of a thick cream. And this is really like a very lotiony cream. It doesn't lather at all, which is fine with me, but I don't know. I just think this packaging is not the best for this type of product. I think I saw they also make a squeezy tube version. That would probably be the one I would go for next because I did like the product itself. It was really just the packaging I couldn't get down with. So anyway, very affordable. I think it was like $4 or $5 at Target. So I might repurchase it, but I'm not like running out to repurchase it. I actually am using the Billy shaving cream right now. I also finally bought the Billy like razor, which I'm loving. So much better than the safety razor. Side note here, I was using a safety razor, hated it, just wasn't for me. So I switched to Billy and their shaving cream is really good. So that might be the one I continue to use instead of this. All right, so this next one is a very exciting empty from my project pan. This is the Wet n Wild Walking on Eggshells Eyeshadow Quad. I was working on using this up for so, so long. I'm sure you are all very used to hearing about this if you've been following along with my project pan. This is the thing that I turned into a Franken bronzer that was in this packaging for the last like 6 months or so. I'm so stinking happy that this is done. I can finally put this into my year-end makeup empties bin and move on with my life. This was, wow, huge accomplishment. I'm so, so happy to be finished with that. I did share that in my most recent project pan update. If you missed it, I can link it down below, but wow, that was crazy. I wasn't expecting to even be done with it this month. I thought definitely by the end of the year, but definitely didn't think this soon. So I'm so, so proud of myself. Okay, another couple of Paula's Choice skin recovery products I also used up, and these were actually in my big like 25 item end of year project pan, along with actually the lip balm as well. So here's a few empties from that, but this is their Replenishing Moisturizer with hyaluronic acid and peptides. This is actually the second one of these that I've gone through. I do really like this, and I did repurchase this once because this is the second one I had, and I do love it, but I just found more affordable alternatives. I really like the Versed Skin Soak Moisturizer. That one's a little bit cheaper than this. So I might go back to this in the future because I do feel like my skin really likes it. And it's just a nice, rich, hydrating moisturizer. Great, like it says, for dry, very dry skin. I even feel like you don't necessarily have to have super dry skin to use any of these skin recovery products, but it's great, especially for tretinoin. All right, so this took forever to use up. This is a Paula's Choice Skin Recovery Super Antioxidant Concentrate Serum with retinol. This has a very low percentage of retinol. It's something like 0.01 or 0.02 or something like that. This is what I was using as like my retinol serum before I got prescribed tretinoin. And so ever since then, I've just been using this on my neck since you can't really put tretinoin on your neck. I mean, you can, but that skin is just a little bit too sensitive. So that's what I used it for. Even though this is a rather small tube, I felt like it took me 1,000 years to use this up. Like definitely a year and a half I had this on my bathroom counter. So good like bang for your buck, I think. And this was nice. I did notice when I first started using it, it did kind of make my skin a little bit peely and dry like around my nose. So I would recommend when you start out with this, if you're totally new to retinol, layer it over your moisturizer rather than underneath and just kind of start like once a week and then work your way up. But it was a nice like very kind of emollient feeling serum, almost kind of oily in a way, not in a bad way, but you know what I mean. But anyway, I wouldn't repurchase it just because I don't really have a need for retinol serums anymore, but I do think it's a good like starter retinol serum for like dry and or sensitive skin. Quick samples here. These are both from Drybar. This is their liquid glass shampoo and conditioner. I loved these. I think I only got like 2 uses out of each one. They made my hair feel so nice, so soft, so healthy. If these weren't $30 a bottle, I would totally buy them, but Drybar is just so expensive. Oh, but if I were like rich and or money was just not an object, I would probably exclusively use like Drybar and Amika hair products because they're expensive. I do notice a difference. I just can't possibly justify spending $30 on a shampoo or a conditioner at this time in my life. Okay, then this actually was interesting, and I actually have another like little deluxe sample size tube of this as well. This is the Smashbox Photo Finish Vitamin Glow Primer. I think I really like this. I definitely noticed a smoothing effect with this. I felt like I wasn't able to get quite enough of a feel for it with this little sample, but I'm glad that I get to keep using it because I do have that little deluxe sample tube. It's kind of like this size-ish. Potentially a really nice primer. I did really like it the few times I used it from this. But I feel like you don't really hear many people talking about this. Do any of you guys use this? I mean, I feel like it's pretty good. Especially coming from someone who is not normally a primer believer. Took me by surprise. All right, another product from my big year-end project pan. This is the Live Clean Daily Moisturizing Body Lotion. This is a Canadian brand, actually. I think they might sell some of their products in the US, but I don't think they sell this in the US. My Canadian friend Jess actually sent me this when we did like a swap last year, and I really enjoyed this. If you can get this where you live, I think it's a really nice body lotion. It's fragrance-free. I think they do also make fragranced versions, but it's nice. Sinks in quickly, doesn't feel like super heavy or sticky on your skin, but it definitely moisturizes. If I were to buy this again, I would get a scent because I wasn't in love with the fragrance-free smell. You know how sometimes fragrance-free products have a little bit of a smell? I didn't love that. And I also just love body lotions with scent to them. I forgot to mention, but this 4-3 Beauty bottle, while I love it, it leaks like crazy. If you ever like knock it over or, you know, don't ever like travel with this, even though like the pump does technically lock, it just leaks out the side. So even though, I mean, there's basically nothing in here, but it's still leaking everywhere. So that's the only downside to this. I forgot to mention that. I have this little mini of the Hello Activated Charcoal Extra Freshening Mouthwash. This was also really nice, actually. I'm usually am not a mouthwash person, but this kind of got me back into mouthwash. I don't think I'd repurchase this particular one because it's black and it kind of makes a mess in your sink, and I just found that a little bit annoying, but I did like the taste and it definitely made my mouth feel extra clean. Right now I have one from Tom's and it's like their fluoride mouthwash. That one's really nice too, and I think I would go for a fluoride mouthwash over a non-fluoride one just because that seems to be what most dentists recommend. Okay, so this is something I've been raving about for a long time, and I think I'm kind of considering not repurchasing this. I don't know, we'll see. This is the Method Fragrance Booster in the Ginger Mango scent. It seems like they changed this. There was a long stretch of time where this was sold out everywhere, and I think they were just having like supply chain issues, totally understandable. But then it came back, and the beads were just not the same. They were like these weird little like chunks, but they weren't like spherical beads anymore like they used to be. So I don't know if they changed the formula. I also felt like it just wasn't freshening up my laundry quite as much as it used to. And it's like $10 a bottle, which I'm kind of starting to realize that is a lot of money, and that really does add up, especially when I go through this like maybe once every 3 months. It's just kind of expensive. So I don't know. I used to really love this, and the ginger mango scent is really nice. I just felt like something changed with it and I'm a little let down. So I don't know, we'll see. Maybe one day I will buy it again if they fix whatever was going on with the beads, but until then I think I'm gonna hold off and just save some money because it is kind of pricey. Okay, these last three products are also from my big year-end project pan. I've been finishing a lot of those items. So first I have the Kopari California Glow Enzyme Scrub. This is meant to be a facial scrub. I just don't use scrubs on my face, so instead I used it up on my body. I think it was a little bit maybe too fine of a scrub for my body, like very, very gentle. But if you like face scrubs, you might like this. It had very, very tiny exfoliating particles. I actually am currently using the Kopari body scrub, like it's actually meant for the body. That is really nice. So yeah, I just didn't really feel any sort of way about this. I would not repurchase it. Then I have the Bliss Lemon and Sage Body Butter Maximum Moisture Cream. I just used this as a hand cream. I kept it on my desk. There was nothing terrible about this, but I just feel like this was one of those hand creams that almost left my hands feeling more dry. Right as you're applying it, it's like, oh yes, that feels nice. But then once it kind of sinks in, my hands almost feel a little bit dry again. So didn't love that, but happy to have used it up. And then finally, I actually have, you might be surprised to see this in this category, but this is the Coco Kind Daily SPF, has SPF 32 in it. I really liked this at first, And this was actually my number two mineral sunscreen this year in my yearly sunscreen roundup and ranking video, which I can link for you below. My number one was the Kinship. Still love that one. The more I used this, I grew to like it less and less. So some days it would just randomly give me a major white cast, whereas other days it wouldn't do that. So I don't know what that was all about. And even though this was a very hydrating feeling sunscreen and it definitely was very glowy, I also felt like underneath makeup, it would almost make my dry patches look worse. And it would also cause my makeup to look more dry towards the end of the day. If you have dry skin, you might know what I mean, but sometimes your makeup, it breaks down on your face, but in a way that just looks dry, like especially around this area for me. And that is kind of what I felt like this did. And I even have like a mattifying sunscreen that I'm currently using from Unsun, and I feel like that one doesn't accentuate dry patches at all, which is surprising for a mattifying sunscreen. So I don't know, I just kind of started liking this less and less. Same price point as the Kinship one, and I feel like that one's just way better. Yeah, I wouldn't repurchase this after all. It's not the worst ever. Like, I have tried way worse mineral sunscreens. This is definitely among the top like 50% of mineral sunscreens that I've tried, you know, but I just grew not to like it that much, so kind of glad to be done with it. But those are all my empties. We have an empties bin now. But thank you again to the Naughty Goat Soaps for sponsoring today's video. I will have all their information linked down below in the description box. So excited to be sharing this brand with you. I think they're just a wonderful company. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel if you've not already. And otherwise, I will talk to you again very soon in my next video. Bye.